What is up, Fistic Fam Bam? All right, this workout today we're gonna be doing is a B&B workout. So we're gonna be using a dumbbell. We're gonna use the punching bag, but remember, you don't have to have a punching bag to do the workout. But if you do, grab your B&B gloves so that you can lift those weights as well. I'm gonna be using 120 pound weight. You can use whatever size suits you. No overhead on this, but we will hit some buys and some buns on this workout. Combo of the day, you know how we do it. It's gonna have some lateral movement. It is pretty dope. So make sure that you watch that in slow motion. And subscribe, like, all that fun stuff. And I'll see you on the next one. We're going to come in with a jab. And we're gonna do some lateral movement on this combination, as you can see. And we're also gonna throw two lefts. So we're gonna jab in, step over with the right uppercut, and then drag slightly with the left hook. Pull back, and then fire a left uppercut. So again, we're gonna have some lateral movement in this combination that we're working on. And then also doubling up on that left at the end, the hook and the uppercut. This will be the combination we'll be working in between all of our rounds of our weights. So again, we're gonna be doing strength training. Now this is just getting in a round with the combination. So you're always gonna want to pop that jab, get the nice range, stay relaxed in the shoulders. Lateral movement is key in boxing, so you want to work on that when you're working on a punching bag and shadow boxing, of course. So if you don't have a bag for this workout, you can do all of this shadow boxing. If you do have a bag, of course, grab some B&B boxing gloves so that you can do the strength training in between your boxing rounds without missing a beat. You can also drink your water with them on and do all sorts of things. Use your phone, whatever you need to do. Working that bag. We're going to be working it until we get to our strength training round, which is going to be coming up now. All right, on this one, we're going to be doing an RDL and then to a row. So, and I'm just going to switch back and forth here. So we're coming down, making sure our hips are pushed back, a slight bend in the knee, chest out, shoulders back. And then when you pull that weight, pull it to your hip. We're working on that back, so making sure to feel it between those shoulder blades. All right, now we're going back to our bag work. Again, that combination is getting worked into all of our bag work. So make sure that you're also throwing everything else. The jab is super important, again, for setting things up, keeping at a good range, always moving those feet. Never get stuck in the mud. Boxing's a lot about moving around, so get used to doing that. Of course, there's a time and a place to be in the pocket where you're not moving your feet, you know, like Canelo, right? And you're just working on defense on the upper body. But you want to have it all. You want to have a full package, so make sure you can move your feet. All right, now we're getting into our next strength training exercise. We're coming down into... it's kind of a sumo squat, but I'm holding that weight down center, and then I'm just going into a curl, and I'm just alternating here. Just remember when you're curling that those elbows are gonna stay tucked into your side, dropping down and pulling up. And you don't need to go all the way up on your bicep curl. You can go about 3/4 of the way up. So whatever works for you. Just try not to swing too much as you're doing those curls, and stay heavy in your heels.